As Shakespeare's heroes come to maturity and manhood, he is concerned with their responsibilities, both in their personal and professional lives. Here is one of his great soldiers, Harry Percy, known as Hotspur, defending himself against a charge of insubordination in a battle before his sovereign, King Henry IV.
My liege, I did deny no prisoners. But I remember when the fight was done, when I was dry with rage and extreme toil, breathless and faint, leaning upon my sword, came there a certain lord, neat and trimly dressed, fresh as a bridegroom, and his chin new reaped, showed like a stubble land and harvest home. He was perfumed like a milliner, and twixt his finger and his thumb he held a pouncet box, which ever and anon he gave his nose and took away again, which therewith angered, when it next came there, took it in snuff. And still he smiled and talked, and as the soldiers bore dead bodies by, he called them untaught knaves, unmannerly, to bring a slovenly, unhandsome course betwixt the wind and his nobility. With many holiday and lady terms he questioned me, among the rest demanded my prisoners in your majesty's behalf. I then all smarting, with my wounds being cold, to be so pestered with a popinjay, out of my grief and my impatience, answered neglectingly, I know not what he should or he should not, for he made me mad to see him shine so brisk and smell so sweet, and talk so like a waiting gentlewoman of guns and drums and wounds. God save the mark, and telling me the sovereign's thing on earth was parmaceti for an inward bruise. And that it was great pity so it was, that villainous saltpeter should be digged out of the bowels of the harmless earth, which many a good tall fellow had destroyed so cowardly. And but for these vile guns, he would himself have been a soldier. This bald, unjointed chat of his, my lord, I answered indirectly as I said, and I beseech you, let not this report come current for an accusation betwixt my love and your high majesty.